Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Palm Sunday of the Passion of the Lord. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. Hosanna in the highest.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we begin the solemn week of our celebration, preparing for our celebration of the great Easter Triduum, let us ask the Lord to send us His Spirit, that we may be able to participate in the Passion and Cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, that we may truly celebrate the triumph of our Lord in the Easter mysteries. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ the King in exaltation may reach the eternal Jerusalem through Him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you now, if you have holy water, to sprinkle holy water in your branches at home. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel of the Lord's entrance into Jerusalem.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus and his disciples drew near to Jerusalem, to Bethpage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village opposite you, and immediately on entering it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone should say to you, 'Why are you doing this?' reply, 'The master has need of it and will send it back here at once.' So they went off and found a colt tethered at a gate outside on the street, and they untied it. Some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing untying the colt?' They answered them just as Jesus had told them to, and they permitted them to do it. So they brought the colt to Jesus and put their cloaks over it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut from the fields. Those preceding him, as well as those following, kept crying out, 'Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of our father David that is to come. Hosanna in the highest.'" My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who as an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed His lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in His resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. "The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear, that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. My God, my God, why have you abandoned me?
My God, my God, why have you abandoned me?
All who see me scoff at me. They mock me with parted lips. they wagged their heads. He relied on the Lord. Let him deliver him. Let him rescue him if he loves him.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
Indeed, many dogs surround me. A pack of evildoers closes in upon me. They have pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
They divide my garments among them, and for my vesture they cast lots. But you, O Lord, be not far from me. O help, hasten to aid me.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
I will proclaim your name to my brethren. In the midst of the assembly, I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him. All you descendants of Jacob, give glory to him. Revere him, all you descendants of Israel.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Verse before the Gospel. Glory and praise to you, O Christ. Christ became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name of which is above every name. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As soon as morning came, the chief priests with the elders and the scribes, that is, the whole Sanhedrin, held a council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
He said to him in reply,
"You say so."
The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned him,
"Have you no answer? See how many things they accuse you of."
Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now, on the occasion of the feast, he used to release to them one prisoner whom they requested. A man called Barabbas was then in prison, along with the rebels who had committed murder in a rebellion. The crowd came forward and began to ask him to do for them as he was accustomed. Pilate answered,
"Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews?"
For he knew that it was out of envy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate again said to them in reply,
"Then what do you want me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?"
They shouted again,
"Crucify him."
Pilate said to them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
They only shouted the louder,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them and, after he had Jesus scourged, handed him over to be crucified. The soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is, the praetorium, and assembled the whole cohort. They clothed him in purple and, weaving a crown of thorns, placed it on him. They began to salute him with,
"Hail, King of the Jews,"
and kept striking his head with the reed and spitting upon him. They knelt before him in homage, and when they had mocked him, they stripped him off the purple cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him out to crucify him. They pressed into service a passerby, Simon, a Cyrenian, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. They brought him to the place of Golgotha, which is translated place of the skull. They gave him wine jugged with myrrh, but he did not take it. Then they crucified him and divided his garments by casting lots for them to see what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." With him, they crucified two revolutionaries, one on his right and one on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying,
"Aha! You who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days, save yourself by coming down from the cross."
Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes mocked him among themselves and said,
"He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down now from the cross, that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also kept abusing him. At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon, and at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani,"
which is translated, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Some of the bystanders who heard it said,
"Look, he is calling Elijah."
One of them ran, soaked a sponge with wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to take him down."
Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. The veil of the sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was the Son of God."
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of the younger James and Joses and Salome. These women had followed him when he was in Galilee and ministered to him. There were also many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When it was already evening, since it was the day of preparation, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a distinguished member of the council, who was himself awaiting the kingdom of God, came and courageously went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate was amazed that he was already dead. He summoned the centurion and asked him if Jesus had already died. And when he learned of it from the centurion, he gave the body to Joseph. Having bought a linen cloth, he took him down, wrapped him in the linen cloth, and laid him in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. Then he rolled a stone against the entrance to the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joses, watched where he was laid.
My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today we begin the solemn observation of Holy Week, the solemn week of remembering the cross and resurrection of our Lord. Maybe just 3 points to reflect on today as we begin with the Palm Sunday of the Lord's Passion. Number one is the irony, no? The irony and the paradox of the liturgy that we're celebrating, no? In the sense that at the beginning we read the people welcoming Jesus, proclaiming him, no? Hosanna in the highest, proclaiming him as the Messiah. And then after that, a few days later, they are the same crowd that condemns Jesus to death, that begins his passion. No? And perhaps to reflect on that our lives really are full of paradoxes, no? And really a life that is very ironic, that sometimes we also have these two sides to us. No? And precisely it is this grace of the cross and resurrection that will help us reconcile and integrate our lives, no? To overcome the irony and paradoxes of our life. That first point to reflect on, and perhaps the grace to pray for, to become more integrated as persons, as followers of Christ during this Holy Week. Then the second point that I invite you to reflect on is we call this the Palm Sunday of the Passion of our Lord. While it is true that the Passion, as we read, was a passion of suffering, you must also understand that the deepest desire of our Lord was to follow God's will, that His desire and passion was to be lovingly obedient to the Father's will, and which was to save us through the cross and the resurrection. And that is the second point that I invite you to reflect on. What is your deepest passion? What is your deepest desire in terms of following God's will, in terms of following Christ, concretely in your life? What is that deepest desire and passion? And then the third and final point is that we see now the cross and resurrection, and we will celebrate that in the coming days during the Easter Triduum. But again, to realize that it is the cross and resurrection, the perfect offering of Christ in love, that loving obedience, that loving sacrifice, that overcame death and the evil of men. It overcame sin, death, and all evil of men. That is a sure and certain victory. Siguro pag nilayan ho natin itong 30 punto in ito sa pagsisimula natin ng Semana Santa. Hilingin natin na ang ating mga buhay ay mabuo, ano, maging holy, maging buo at integrated sa pamamagitan ng ating pagninilay, pagdarasal, at paghingi ng biyaya ng Semana Santa. At hilingin din natin na sana ay muli natin makita, kagaya ng Panginoong Hesukristo, ano ba yung pinakamalalim natin na pagnanais? What is our deepest desire? Kagaya ng Panginoon na ang kanyang pinakamalalim na pagnanais ay ang maging mapagtalima sa kagustuhan ng Ama, ng buong pag-ibig na maging mapagtalima. Ano yung ating pinakamalalim na pagnanais upang tayo ay makasunod sa Panginoon at maging mapagtalima rin sa kagustuhan ng Ama sa ating buhay? At ang pangatlo ay ang ating paninindigan at ating paniniwala na ang sakripisyo ng Panginoon ngayon na pinagdiriwang natin sa Semana Santa ay dinaig ang kasalanan, ang kamatayan, at lahat ng kasamaan. Lalong-lalo na ngayon sa kalagitnaan ng pandemya, ng maraming pagdurusa at maraming kasamaan na nagpapaligid sa atin, hilingin natin muli ang pag-asa at ang lakas ng ating pananampalataya. In the midst of so much suffering, may the cross and resurrection of Christ remind us that He has overcome all evil in the world, sin and death, and that we will share in the glory of the resurrection. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray to our Heavenly Father, who will that all human beings be saved through the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of His Son, Jesus Christ. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Pope, bishops, priests, and deacons continue to profess their faith in God in an indifferent and sometimes hostile world. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May government and civil leaders follow the example of Christ, who came not to be served but to serve and to give His life for the good of the people. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we support the Alay Kapwa program as our way of responding to the challenges of restoring social justice and helping the weak and the needy. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May those who continue to crucify Jesus by acts of violence against their brothers and sisters be led to the road of repentance and atone for the evils they have done. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions.
Let's also pray especially that through the passion and the cross of our Lord, we may overcome this pandemic and that the Lord may protect us from this virus and heal all those who have been affected by this virus. Father, look tenderly on your children as we follow Christ in the joy of his entrance to Jerusalem, as well as in the pains of the sacrifice on Calvary. May we be worthy to enter your kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Through the passion of your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to restore our hope and faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in serving and healing the victims of the virus. Protect them and grant them your inspiration to sustain them in body, mind, heart, and spirit. And for those who fell ill and passed on, reward them with eternal life with you and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe too and grant them your guidance, most especially our leaders, to selflessly work for the common good and find meaning in their service. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their sufferings be their participation in the suffering of your Son that redeemed us. For all who are infected, heal them and grant them full recovery. Continue to guide our experts tasked to find cures, to find effective vaccines and cures for this virus. Use them as instruments in your healing hands. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Nourish with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so that by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Look, we pray, O Lord, on us, your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ did not hesitate to be delivered into the hands of the wicked and submit to the agony of the cross, he who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go and prepare for the great Easter Triduum.
Thanks be to God.
Again, on Alay Kapwa Sunday, we'd like to thank all of you. Marami pong salamat. As we promised, no, we will give you the running total of our Alay Kapwa Movement Fund. We have, as of Thursday, we have 8,578,449.40 donations from you. Thank you very much. And again, on the Divine Mercy Sunday, we will launch the first program in education for the poor and the vulnerable members of our community. Have a very prayerful Holy Week, and may we truly celebrate the great grace of our faith, the cross and resurrection.
Sa ngalan po ng Caritas Philippines, ang Episcopal Commission on Social Action, Justice and Peace, buong puso po kami nagpapasalamat sa maraming mga tulong na aming natanggap mula sa ating mga kababayan sa ginagawa nating Alay Kapwa Program. Kahit nakukunti po, napakahalaga ang inyong mga tulong at marami po tayong matutulungan na ating mga kapatid na naghihirap. Ang inyong tulong po ay napakahalaga sapagkat piso mo ay mahalaga kung sa puso ay nagmumula.